There's an interesting new shift that's happening now in the cellular world that really intersects blockchain. When we're transitioning from 4G networks like LTE to 5G networks, the tower range is actually shrinking dramatically. So 4G towers have a range of like 30 miles, 50 kilometers. 5G towers have a range of about 500 feet, you know, 150 meters. So the number of towers that are expected to operate for 5G is going to be orders of magnitude larger. So imagine now a world where you have, you know, one of these routers, one of these towers every a couple hundred feet in a large metropolitan area. Even as just a normal person that's commuting office to work, you're going to be switching and connected to dozens of these at a time. And if these are provided by different carriers, different tower providers, different operators, it creates kind of this nightmare real-time billing problem that these old school like asset-based databases that are tracking your usage in the network really can't handle the complexity of the system. Blockchain is a really fundamentally amazing stack for tracking identity and billing, right? If you use cryptography and use effectively almost like a token-based system for paying for bandwidth, a device that's traveling, you know, between all of these towers can reconnect on demand and pay for quality of service, pay for bandwidth, and all of this can be tracked automatically between a very large set of people and set of providers. Other kinds of use cases that we're seeing early signs of adoption are more Web2 companies that have large user bases starting to introduce crypto elements into their networks. These networks traditionally have tens of millions of users, 20 millions of users, and they simply cannot operate on current infrastructure, but they can on Solana. I think when you look at our team, it's not surprising that we're able to build this ridiculously fast blockchain. And it's because most of the team has worked together at Qualcomm, working on optimizing high performance cellular networks, wireless networks, operating systems. I mean, we were there really from 2G days when you had flip phones to like the latest and greatest crazy high performance Android devices. From our perspective, we have already built networks that serve billions of users that have the highest security requirements, that are attacked by the most well-funded opponents. And we kind of have the skill set to do this. What we're building has a possibility to change the world, because I think blockchain is one of those key technologies that is truly revolutionary. You know, if you look at the world's GDP, about 20% of it's spent on financial services. And right now, a lot of that cost just goes to inefficient systems that require a lot of manpower and a lot of regulation. If you truly have a system, like a computer that cannot be hacked, fraud is impossible, you can start moving all those services into software and reducing those costs. You know, if we succeed, potentially 20% of that GDP is given back to the people, and we can work 4 days out of 5 and get the same quality of life.